From the station that made country music famous, 650 AM WSM, this is a Coffee, Country, and Cody podcast.
Hi, it's Charlie Maddox, and in this episode, we sit down with Steve Wariner and Michael Ray. What a fun visit as they zoomed in with us on Coffee, Country, and Cody to chat about their upcoming appearance on the Grand Ole Opry.
Maybe the funniest quote I've ever heard regarding dating someone, and I don't mean dating as in a romantic dating,
yes,
but putting someone in their place regarding your age or a particular event in your life and their age, just given us by Steve Wariner as a reference to 1982's Kansas City Lights. And Michael Ray, who was born in 1988, 6 years later, to which Steve said, use the guitar strap line again.
Oh, I said, I've got guitar straps older than Michael Ray.
No, that's a music insider joke right there, people.
Oh, my gosh.
I've never heard that in my life.
I love it.
Well, we are awaiting Lee Brice's arrival. But we're going to start with the two of you. First, let me ask you, Steve, where are you going to be on the 6th of June? Not this weekend, but
June 6th. That's the easy one. I'm going to be at the Grand Ole Opry. Whoa. On the stage of the Opry with my buddy Michael Ray and Lee Brice.
Yeah, I was going to ask Michael, where are you going to be on June the 6th?
Michael, where are you going to be, Michael?
Man, it just so happens I'm going to be at the Grand Ole Opry with Steve Wariner and Lee Brice.
That's cool.
I'm going to have my guitar strap with me, too. So
yeah, I just want to see this 32-year-old guitar strap.
And I understand there's another musical guest that will be joining you there that night that won't be able to join us here this morning. Michael?
Yes. My wife, Carly Pearce, will be there as well. So
That's great.
I'll be surrounded by some of the best singers, which means I'll be on vocal rest from now until. So whoever set this up, I appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Well,
that's going to be a special night, man. Yeah. It's going to be so fun. And I love it that the Opry keeps on rocking, you know, it just keeps going and doing what it does. And we'll be in the circle there and having a great time. And, I'm already thinking about it, Michael. I guess you too, but it's going to be odd to see the house empty like that. I don't know that I've ever done it quite like that, but I've done the Opry a lot of ways, but not like that. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, I was thinking about that this morning, actually, and Carly and I talked about that, how inspiring it is that the Opry's continued the show. Yep. And luckily we have, you know, WSM to be able to broadcast the show still to all the fans that can't be there in person.
No but question about it.
I feel like there's something really magical that's going to be felt on that circle in an empty room. I don't know. I'm kind of excited to feel it.
Me too.
We definitely miss the fans, but I'm kind of excited to feel what that's like. Just a bar stool on the Opry stage and feeling all that history, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. And Bill, you know, in 2010, when the flood happened, I remember Pete Fisher, the manager at the Opry, called and said, we're going to take a tour through the Opry in boats. Do you want to go? And I said, I bowed out. I said, no, I can't do it. I don't want to see it that way.
Oh, man.
They actually did a boat tour through the whole building
and
was kind of assessing where it was. And I don't know. I don't know if it was up. As you know, guys, it was up over the, 5 feet over the stage up. And I just couldn't do it. I didn't see it. But this will be a whole new deal here. And it will be almost a spiritual thing. I got a feeling it's going to be.
Yeah. Do you guys have your set list made? Do you know what you're going to sing?
I do not. I don't know. I sort of have an idea. I think we'll do probably four tunes or three, four. I don't each. So I may have to do Holes in the Floor of Heaven.
That'd be
for sure. You know, that particular day, but I don't know. That's the rest is pretty open, I guess. But
that song saved me a Mother's Day 1 year, Steve.
Really?
Yeah. Whoa. I bought my mom was such a big fan, and Mother's Day was that day, and my dad my parents are divorced, and I think he hit the, oh, it's Mother's Day, and I haven't taken you shopping. And so I was like, she loves Steve Wariner, and so you saved my Mother's Day.
Oh, that's awesome. That is so funny.
Let me share a little piece of WSM and Coffee Country and Cody history, Michael. Steve debuted that song back in the days when we had the studio in the park, the Opryland theme park. You remember that, Steve?
Yeah.
Coming and debuting at the world premiere of Holes in the Floor of Heaven on Coffee Country and Cody.
That's exactly right.
What a beautiful song.
And I remember,
Bill, I'll tell you one even deeper on that, that you'll, I don't think you know this, so you'll get a kick out of this. The guy at Capitol Records, when he came and brought you the music, he brought you the demo version of it and not the real record. Do you remember that?
Good morning, Jimmy. If you're out there, he listens still, he says.
I didn't say a name. But we laughed about that, but we all we laugh about it now. But it didn't. The demo was really all it was the same, but not real strings. It was, we hadn't put the strings, real strings yet. So it was basically the same, but fake, cheesy fake strings. And it was as soon as I heard those buzzy fake strings, I went, oh no, that's the demo version. But it was, you know, it was a.
And we had a film crew in the studio, so Steve covered it well. He never, it was just his eyes, and I knew something was wrong. And so to this day, I never see Jimmy Rector that he doesn't say somewhere before the conversation.
Are you serious? Does he really do that?
He will say, and I brought the demo. And we both just burst out laughing as a result. So, and I remember, too, you were saying that Marty Robbins was Mr.
Dialing, you know.
That Marty Robbins was Mr. Teardrop, and that you would now be Mr. Kleenex from now on with that song.
Yeah, there you go. I think so, exactly, you know.
Well, catch me up on quarantine life for the two of you. Michael, we've been able to follow both of you on social media, but and Carly as well. So, Steve, we'll start with you. Well, what have you found yourself doing that you wouldn't normally be doing?
Well, first of all, we jumped into what we like to call Wariner Wednesday. We started doing Facebook Live every Wednesday night. Last night was my 10th. We did a number 10. I've had two guests. Some guys that are doing okay. I had Garth Brooks on one night, and then I had Clint Black on another night. So we didn't want to bore people with a lot of talent, so I bailed out and just did it by myself, you know, after that.
And Michael Ray goes, well, the best I can do is I'm married to Carly Pearce, and she's got a monster single on the radio with Lee Brice right now. So, Michael, what about you individually as well as collectively with Carly?
We've been working on the record, trying to take this time to write and get in the studio. And it's been, you know, different because everybody's from different home studios now. But we've recorded 4 songs for the new album, and grateful that we have all this technology, this way to be able to at least continue to make music and get music out.
Yeah.
And that we can have things like this. You know, Steve said he has Wariner Wednesday, and I've been doing a thing called Honky Tonk Tuesday, where, you know, I love traditional country music. I obviously grew up on 90s country music, and I like going to those places, and there was no honky tonk. So I was like, you know what? We'll bring honky tonks to the living rooms of fans, and have had Mark Wills and different guests on there. So that's what I've been doing. And then Carly and I've just been, we've been busy, you know, actually still during quarantine. So it's been fun.
Michael Ray, Steve Wariner, Lee Brice, Carly Pearce, 6/6/20, not this Saturday, but the following Saturday, June the 6th. They will be at the Grand Ole Opry House in Nashville, Tennessee. Thanks for joining us this morning on Coffee Country and Cody, fellas.
Thank you guys so much.
And if you discover the whereabouts of Lee Brice, please send him our way, would you?
We lost the biggest guy here. We don't know.
And Michael's got the biggest honking coffee mug I have seen to date as a part of these Zoom interviews, filled with wine by his wife, Carly Pearce, I'm sure.
Thanks for listening to our Coffee Country and Cody podcast. Our program director at WSM Radio is J. Patrick Tittle. Our digital producer is Haley Hall. Marketing and promotions director is Amanda Cannon. And I'm Charlie Mattos. If you like what you've heard, make sure you subscribe so you never miss an episode. And leave us a review on iTunes. It really does help new people find the show.